Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. It's been a very long time since I did any videos on speaking fluent English. I had originally done a series of videos on that, and many of my subscribers have been repeatedly asking me for more videos. So I said today let me dedicate this session to speaking fluent English, and the topic for today is tips to speak polite English in day-to-day situations as well as in business meetings. You need to use polite language, because if you don't use the correct language, you might put off others or others might feel offended even though you didn't mean to be rude. So it is very important to learn the use of the correct polite language to be able to make a good impression both in your personal life as well as in your professional life. So it is very important that we choose the right kind of words to avoid appearing rude. Let me give you a simple example of how your first tip is to avoid any negative words. Instead, you can use negative words in a positive way. Let me explain this with an example. Let's say you've gone out shopping with a friend, and your friend is trying to choose a particular dress or sari or whatever it is. And then she picks up a particular piece and says, how do you like it? It looks good, isn't it? But when you look at the color, maybe you just don't like it. But your reaction should not be immediately saying, it's awful, I dislike it. Don't use such strong words. But put it across, put your view across in a more positive way by saying, maybe you could look at a lighter shade, or you could even say, I don't think this color suits you. This way, you are putting your idea across. At the same time, you are not using harsh or rude words. You are putting it across in a very polite and positive way. This could be used for any situation. Here I gave you the example of choosing a dress. Maybe anything. Somebody is deciding to paint his house and they want to choose the color of paint for the rooms. Each person's taste is different. So when you give your opinion on anything, try to put it across in a positive way. The next tip is a very, very basic, simple one, that is of using polite words. Earlier on also I have stressed on this. The three magical words, please, sorry and thank you. Try to use it in as many situations as possible. A simple thing, maybe somebody has a newspaper and you want to have a look at the newspaper. Don't just say, give me the newspaper. Say, please pass the newspaper, or please may I have your newspaper. Say thank you. And also let us say you were not able to listen to what somebody was saying very correctly, you didn't hear it properly. Then you just say sorry, which means that they will repeat it again for you. Another common thing, let's say you are in a hurry to go somewhere and some other people are just blocking your way and standing in the middle and talking over there. You just don't say, move out of the way. That sounds very rude. Although you really want them to move out of the way, but how we put it across is, simply we say, please excuse me. We don't just roughly say, move out of the way. So these simple things, polite words, go a long way in improving your personality. Now the next example is, when somebody interrupts you. Interrupts you meaning, say you're busy in the middle of doing something and somebody just walks into your room. You don't want to be disturbed. So what is your natural reaction? You just say, go away or leave me alone, don't disturb me. Instead of saying that, how can you put it across in a very polite way? You can say, sorry, I'm busy right now, I'll talk to you later. Or this can happen even over the phone. Today all of us are homebound. It's not that we meet each other on a one-to-one, face-to-face. But very often, say, let's say, I call up my friend, but she is busy working on some office project of hers. So what will she say to me? Sorry, I'm busy right now. Can I call you later? Or can we talk later? That is a very polite way of saying, I'm busy now, don't talk to me. Or you can simply say, can we talk later? I'm on a call. Another simple way is, change the focus, shift the focus from you to I. For example, just assume that somebody has given you a set of instructions on how to operate a particular device. But then halfway through you find you are not able to do it properly. Or another very simple situation, somebody has given you directions to reach a particular place. Of course not, I know you have the GPS today. But in other cases, or maybe instructions on how to prepare a particular dish maybe. Okay? And then when you go back to that person and you are not able to do it properly, don't say you didn't explain clearly. Shift the focus back to yourself. Say, sorry, I didn't understand properly. Could you explain it again? So this way you are putting across your message in a very polite way, and the other person will be ready to explain it a second time to you. When you want to change a direct question into a polite request, very often you can use the modals. The modals are may, might, could and would. This changes the sentence into one which has a very polite tone. So instead of just saying, I want a cup of coffee or get me a cup of coffee, you can just say, could I have some coffee please? Or could you pass the water please? When we use the modal as could, it gives a very polite form to the sentence. Or if you just want to, you want to take a call, you want to have some privacy, so you want the other person to leave the room maybe. Then you can say, could you step out for a moment please? Could you step out for a moment please? Instead of saying just go out, that is not good manners. So whenever you use could or would, for example, would it be possible to meet tomorrow? Could you call me up tomorrow please? I am busy today. May I come in? Things like this. Or even the word might. It might be a good idea to carry an umbrella. So this way you give your suggestions using the modals so that your sentence becomes a polite request instead of just being a direct statement. Now let's say you have called up somebody and that person is busy with his office work, and you want to know when he will be free to talk to you or to discuss something with you. Now simply what we would say is, tell me when you are free. So this tell me can be slightly changed to, let me know when you are free, or let me know when you are a little less busy. Let me know what would be a suitable time to call you. So when you say let me know, it sounds more polite. So it does not mean that tell me is wrong. All I am trying to explain today is, you put across your sentence in a more polite way so that you don't come across as being rude. And once you make this a practice in your everyday conversation, it will come very naturally to you. Just as using modals changes it to a polite request, sometimes slightly changing the grammar of the sentence also can make it into a polite request. You are talking to somebody and you say, can we meet tomorrow? Now, a better way of framing that same sentence without any change in meaning would be, I was wondering if we could meet tomorrow. This way, it gives the other person a feeling that you are considering his time and you are being quite polite. Let me repeat the sentence for you. I was wondering if we could meet tomorrow, or I was wondering if you could help me out with this project. These are the ways you can use it. But then, in certain situations, this may not always be possible, because there do arise circumstances where we have to disagree or we have to provide negative feedback. There also, let us say somebody has suggested a particular idea for his way of carrying out a particular task. So immediately we should not say, oh, this is a bad idea, it will not work. That will sound very rude. But you want to again express that you are in disagreement with him, you don't feel that it is a good idea. Then what do you say? I don't think it's such a good idea. See the difference? Instead of saying it is a bad idea, you are softening it. You are saying, I don't think it's such a good idea. I have a few concerns. meaning I feel that there might be some shortfalls if we go ahead with your idea. Or let us say you have to tell a give a negative feedback or give some small bad news to somebody, and someone comes and asks you, what happened to my proposal? Has it been, have I been selected? Has my project been selected or has my proposal been shortlisted? So you can just say your proposal has not been shortlisted. But again, don't be so negative. Try to soften the effect, and you can use the phrase, I'm sorry. I'm sorry to say that your proposal has not been shortlisted. See, the meaning does not change, but the effect changes, that it becomes much more softer when you put it across, I'm sorry to say. Or let us say somebody asks you to come to keep the project ready, say by 3:30 in the afternoon. So instead of just saying, no, it's not possible, I can't give it by 3:30, you can put it across as, I'm afraid it may not be possible. Here, afraid does not mean fear, but here you're telling that it is not easy for you. I'm afraid it may not be possible to complete it by 3. Maybe by tomorrow morning it will be ready. That way your conversation is better and you sound more polite too. Similarly, on the telephone also, or maybe face to face, you meet a stranger, don't just say, who are you? You can say politely, may I know your name please? If you have not heard properly what the other person is saying, as I said earlier, don't just say what. Say, could you repeat that please? Again, see the use of the modal could. Could you repeat that please? Now, let us say you are having a discussion and you find the other person is telling something which you know is wrong. So, just don't say you are wrong. That sounds a bit rude. You can put it across as, I think you might be mistaken. Being mistaken has the same meaning as being wrong, but you put it across in a polite way. I think you might be mistaken. Or you can begin your sentence with, actually, this is what happened, not the way you think. So you can start a sentence with, actually, or I think you might be mistaken. Again, when you are giving instructions, let us say you are giving instructions, you are the boss, you are giving instructions to your subordinates, don't say, do this by evening. Say, it would be great if you could complete this by evening. See how much better it sounds to the ear, how much more softened it is. When somebody tells you, do this by evening, it seems like an order. But when they tell you, it would be great if you could complete this by evening, then what happens? Internally, you start thinking, yes, I was somehow trying to finish this by evening and submit it. So this way, people will like you for being polite, and you will create a wonderful impression both in your personal field as well as in your job or wherever you are working. This way, people will like you for being polite, and you will also create a very good impression. Thank you for watching the video, and those who are my new subscribers, you will find a complete section on how to speak fluent English on my channel playlist. You can go through those videos also. We'll meet again in another interesting video from Geeta's Kitchen. Please subscribe to Geeta's Kitchen and don't forget to tap the bell icon for notification about my latest updates. Thank you.